गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट ओवर ईयर क्लास. वेलकम टू द डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ APS. नाउ दिस इज पवन कुमार एंड टूडे आई विल स्टार्ट लेक्चर वन एंड स्टार्ट चैप्टर 5 कंटिन्यूटी एंड डिफरेंशिबिलिटी. सो टूडे इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो लिसन केयरफुली. इन प्रीवियस क्लास और क्लास 11th यू हैव ऑलरेडी studied limits and derivative and also continuity. You have checked continuity at many functions. So this is the questions or this is the topic related to continuity and differentiability. With the help of continuity, with the help of limits, I will check the function is continuous or not. So let us start with the first definition, continuity. And what is continuity? See everyone, let y is equal to fx be a function then the function fx is said to be continuous in an interval, continuous in an interval if for every value of x, if for every value of x in that intervals y exist, y exist. So again see, so now again listen, first of all you will consider y is equal to fx be a function, any functions, then the function fx is said to be continuous in an intervals, and intervals element that is known as domain elements. If for every value of x is domain elements, for every value of x in that intervals y exist, means for every value of x y should be any value. So what is the definition of continuity? For any function to be continuous, for every value of y x there should be a values of y exist. Now see the example of continuous function. Let us consider, this is example. Let us consider, this is the function. Consider x-axis and this is y-axis. This is the continuous curve. So this is continuous. Intersection is 0, 0. This curve is continuous. Continuous functions. Suppose any another graph, I am going to draw. This is x-axis. This is intersection of x and y-axis. This curve is break at a point A to B. So this is discontinuous. This curve is discontinuous. Means non-continuous. This is also known as non-continuous. So to see these two examples, we have two conclusions. This curve is continuous and this curve is break from point A and B. So what is the conclusion for continuous function? First point is graph is drawn without lifting the pencil. The graph is drawn without lifting the pencil, without lifting the pencil or pen. So we have drawn by pen, so this is pen. You can write also pencil. Again, graph is drawn to lift the pencil. Lift the pencil. So this is the first conclusion we have seen from graph. Second conclusion is no jump. Second conclusion is no jump. And for discontinuous graph, second conclusion is jump, gap or break. We can say graph as jump, break or gap. Graph as jump, break or gap. So now see the student, we have take two examples of graph. One is continuous, other is non-continuous or discontinuous. So first of all, I have drawn the graph for continuous function. The curve from A to B, A, B, C, D. The curve ABCD is continuous. There is no gap. There is no break or no jump. So this is continuous. We have written graph is drawn without lifting the pencil. Without lifting the pencil, you have drawn this graph. So this is continuous. Graph has no jump or no gap or no breaks. Similarly, non-continuous function is also known as any function is not continuous, so this will be known as non-continuous or discontinuous. Discontinuous and non-continuous both are same. So this is the graph. Suppose this is MN, this is MA, B, C, D. Or suppose C, A, B, D. So the graph is discontinuous at A. The graph is break at A. The graph is continuous from C to A and A to B, that is break. Means at continuous, discontinuous at A, and the graph is continuous from B to D. So this whole graph is discontinuous from at A. This is discontinuous at A. Suppose y is equal to A. This is discontinuous. So now let us see the examples of continuous functions. Any other examples? See. Any other example of continuous functions? Now let us see the example of continuous function. So first of all, I will draw a graph which is continuous. So this is the function y is equal to x, y is equal to sine x. Y is equal to sine x. This function is continuous in the given intervals. This is example one. Second example is the graph of y is equal to mod x. Y is equal to mod x. So y is equal to mod x is the graph. This is y is equal to mod x graph. This is also continuous. Similarly, third graph is, suppose this is the standard equation of parabola. X square is equal to 4ay or y square is equal to 4ax consider. This is the standard equation of right hand parabola. Y square is equal to 4ax. And this figure is symmetric about x-axis and passing through origin. So again, see the figure. This is y square is equal to 4ax, x axis, y axis, and their intersection origin. So this figure is symmetric about x axis and passing through origin. This is also the continuous function. Next, see fourth example. Suppose so y is equal to x square and y is equal to x cube also is in the shape fifth part or fifth figure. See example, x axis, y axis, suppose y is equal to c, y is equal to c is the line parallel to x axis, this is also continuous in the given intervals. So this is the example of continuous functions. In these figures there is no gap, no jump, no break. So this is continuous. Now see the example of discontinuous functions. Example of discontinuous functions. Now suppose first figure is example 1, x axis, y axis, suppose this is the curve and the curve is jumping, means from this point B, suppose A point, this is B point and this is C point. The curve is jumping, means jump. Suppose second figure is this is the break. And third is gap. Suppose this is curve, this is the gap. This is the gap. So this is the example of discontinuous function. So see fourth example is suppose fx is equal to 1, 2 for x is less than equal to 0, for x is less than equal to 0, I am writing this part here, 1, 2 such that x is less than equal to 0 and x is greater than 0. So 1 is less than equal to 0, suppose this is the point 1 and this is the point 2. 1 is less than equal to 0, so x negative is here and x positive is here and y positive is here and y negative is here. So this is the line for x is less than 0 and x is equal to 1. X is less equal to 0, y gives 1. So y is equal to 1 and x is less than 0 and y is equal to 1, you know the line parallel to x axis. Similarly, x is greater than 0, y value is 2, not equal to 2. So this will be node. And parallel to x axis also. This is the point y is equal to 2. So this is the function. You can say the given function is discontinuous. Here is gap, jump or break. So gap, jump or break. So this is the example of discontinuous functions. Now student, I will discuss some properties of continuous functions. So let us start. Now student, I will discuss some properties of continuous function. So first of all, you will consider any two continuous function. Let fx and gx be, let fx and gx be any two continuous function continuous at A, continuous at x is equal to A, then first part, the sum of two continuous function is always continuous at a given point. At a given point, such that f plus g x is continuous at x is equal to A. Similarly, second part, the difference of two continuous function is always continuous at a given point. It means f minus g x is continuous at x is equal to A. Similarly, third is the product of two continuous functions is continuous. the product of two continuous function is continuous at a given point. It means f g x is equal to or is always continuous at x is equal to a. So now the product of two continuous function is continuous at a given point. So function product is f into g, x is continuous at a given point a, a is given point. Similarly, fourth point is the division of two continuous function is always continuous at a given point. So f by g, see everyone, f by g is continuous at x is equal to a such that ga is not equal to 0, because ga belongs to ga is the denominator element, so it cannot be equal to 0 according to the definition of rational part. So this is the property. Now see another property is, now fifth property is a constant function is continuous everywhere. Sixth is a polynomial function is continuous everywhere. Seventh is a rational function is continuous in its domain, because you know rational means px upon qx format, and qx is not equal to 0, it's not defined at q is equal to 0, so its domain is for all real number except qx is not equal to 0. Now eighth point is modulus function is continuous everywhere. Ninth is exponential function is continuous everywhere. Now tenth is trigonometric functions are continuous in their domains. So now this is the 10th point or 10th properties of continuous function. Trigonometrical function is continuous everywhere, exponential is continuous everywhere, modulus is continuous everywhere, rational function is continuous in its domain, trigonometrical is also continuous in its domain, and polynomial is continuous everywhere, constant is continuous in everywhere.